This video is called Blood Memory, and this is something you may have experienced in your own life, but I definitely experience it on a regular basis. You see, I have tendencies and behaviors that apparently are exactly like people in my family that I never knew, I never met, and I am a lot like them in many different ways, despite never having or be influenced by them in any shape or form. And I have other tendencies as well. I like to shoot bows. You know, shooting bows in 2024 does not really have a practical use, especially when you have access to firearms, and I even have access myself, but I mean, comparatively speaking, it's not really worth the time to invest in archery when you could be investing in rifles and whatnot. But I'm still, despite the clear, for lack of a better term, drawbacks, I still prefer to focus on archery. And sure, it has its uses, it has some benefits, but I'll never be the type of guy to argue that archery is a superior form of combat. Or, I mean, some people do. And, you know, I also like to wear armor and hit people and practice with swords and do historical medieval martial arts. There's no rational explanation for this other than the fact that I'm drawn to these activities. I've been drawn to activities my entire life without really having much say in the matter. Another good example of this would be runic scrying, or studying the runes, or being interested in runes. My first experience with runes was when I was 15. It was a chance happening. I was given a set by a family member without really understanding or knowing much about it at all. But I immediately became obsessed, and I just devoured all the literature, all the books, all the knowledge I could find on the matter until I became somewhat competent at understanding them and using them and understanding how to use them and when to use them and why we should use them. And maybe I could get more into that in different videos, but these are just examples of blood memory, right? When I see an Italian person, no, just kidding. Love you, Giorgio. When I see an Italian person, you know, I just have to feel that inner barbarian in me. I just start to stare in autism. No, of course not. I love Italians. What am I saying? Love you, Giorgio. You still owe me a pizza in Rome, by the way. But I know some of you have talked about this. Just let me know in the comments some more specific types of blood memory you've dealt with. And blood memory also has to do with musical talent, artistic talent. I believe people are drawn to different talents based off their blood memory. And blood memory, I think, does mainly involve one's own ancestry. I think definitely, and I've had experiences where it can expand from a non-ancestor, but I think the majority of our blood memory comes from our direct ancestors, from our current bloodlines. And that we typically reincarnate and within our own bloodlines. And I'm not going to go down the Varg route. We're saying like we go to our burial mounds and retrieve our lost loot from our previous lives. But over long periods of time, I can see some sort of transfer of blood and soul families. That just feels right to me, because of course this is not a rational or intellectual discussion by any means. And if you know me, I typically shun those conversations, but no, I mean, unfortunately, a lot of this has been caught up with the woo-woos, with the New Agers, with the whatever they call themselves these days. They kind of take this soul family thing and made it their own spin where they just associate it. It's not that they're even wrong about it. It's just that the fact that it gets associated with those types of people, it just really upsets me because now I have to be associated with people because of things I believe. And oh, it's just so unfortunate. But of course, it's just part of the Kali Yuga we live in, where our true spirituality is being corrupted. And you know, you have fake paths within fake paths within fake paths, and then it's just so hard to wade through it all. And that's what we're doing here. We're trying to wade through it all together. And I think, you know, clearer pictures are developing of what it really means to be what we are. And again, I think blood memory is deeply connected. And veneration of your ancestors. Be proud of your ancestors and worship them. Not in a, you know, kneeling before them and groveling type of way, because that's kind of how we've been programmed in thinking what worship is, but in a more respectful and grateful manner. Being grateful for everything that they've done for us and what they even continue to do, because many of us have ancestors who are still alive. But oh, these guys were talking about how ancestor worship is problematic because our ancestors did horrible things. And look, yeah, they did do horrible things. I mean, that's your definition of horrible, your modern interpretation with your modern morals and your basically these quote unquote heathens or polytheists or cultists are doing is they're putting a Christian lens of good and evil, applying it to their own ancestors, and then judging them as bad people because they did this and that, were involved in some shady activities, to say the least. But how and why would you even do that? What is the point of being a heathen if you're applying a Christian lens of morality to basically everything that you're trying to overcome? Just be a Christian. I think a lot of these people, you know, they don't like being a Christian, not because they don't disagree with it theologically, but because they disagree with it politically. And so they wrap themselves in pagan aesthetics and they just hop around with their cartoon character avatar. And I will never understand it. That's okay. They can do that. Just do you. I know you're going to judge. I know as soon as I get discovered, wow, it's going to be a fun day because I'm going to be called all sorts of things. I don't really care. I do not care. That's the thing. I don't have this fear of societal acceptance because I'm not accepted. None of us are accepted. And we've all found each other because we feel that lack of acceptance, which is fine. We will accept each other because we understand each other and they don't. So who cares about what they think is okay to believe in? Oh, you better not believe in things that we don't approve of. Otherwise, we're going to judge you. Wow, big deal. What are you going to do? My blood memory is already activated when I see you anyway, so tough luck with that one. No, but it is an interesting phenomenon, these behaviors that we tend to take in from our ancestors. And I heard tales of like great grandparents and their mannerisms and temperaments. I'm just like, that's me. That's literally me. It's a literally me moment, and it's amazing. And then you kind of get into the whole genetics thing, and you know, I even think, even now, genetics are way underestimated in terms of behavioral tendencies. Like, I would say it's like 90%. 90%. All right? I'm throwing it out there. Deal with it. 90% genetics, 10% environment. If you don't like it, I'm sorry, but look. Just look at pit bulls. All right? I'm going on tangent. Pit bulls. You know, people say it's just, oh, pit bulls are just like this because it was the way they were raised. And if you raise them good, if they're a good owner, if they're a good owner, buddy, then nothing bad will happen. Okay, so pit bulls have the number one tendency to attack you. And then the closest second is German Shepherds, and it's not a close second. It's a very, very far second. I'm talking like deviations away from even being next to first place. But it's because they were just bred to kill. Born to kill. That's the pit bull blood memory. The pit bull blood memory is them being in these arenas, literal dog gladiators going at each other, ripping, just going absolute mental on these people. And if you want to deny that, then deny it, but I accept it, and I see it. So when I see pit bulls, I am extremely wary, just because I understand that they have that blood memory in them. And, you know, if you see that, you just gotta watch out for it. So yeah, you know, there's some practical knowledge within this as well. The blood memory will tell you or what to do and what not to do and what to avoid. It's just a bit of wisdom, I think, that can benefit everyone's life if you understand the concept of blood memory. And, you know, my ancestors, well, we can talk about my ancestors. I mean, what can I say? Oh, very likely they were part of the Highland Clearance, so they got booted out by the nobles. But another thing is, like, who was your ancestor? Like, when do you cut off the line? Because basically we're all kind of descendants from nobles, because at one point the nobles started outbreeding the peasants, so a lot of us are actually have noble ancestry at some point down the line. So at one point, do you consider your ancestry noble and peasant? No, I'm definitely a peasant. There's no question about that. I'm freaking stuck here in Canada, so I'm definitely a peasant. That's okay. I embrace it. I would have been one of the peasants who, like, rises. This is my, like, headcanon. I'm, like, the peasant who rises up because I'm so, like, big that the nobles are like, all right, well, we can promote him to at least a man-at-arms. So, okay, I'm not just a peasant, I'm like a man-at-arms. I'm not a knight, obviously, because, you know. But I'd like to think I got up to that next level of man-at-arms. So yeah, peasants. And because I'm a peasant, I like to work. I really do enjoy work. I've done manual jobs my whole life. That's been the majority of my employment, career-wise, has been just me slugging away in the pits of doom, in the swine pits, just slugging it away my whole freaking life. And you know what? I love it. Oh, your back. Your back's gonna hurt there, buddy. When no, your back is fucked, actually, because you sit at a desk all day. Well, my back is impenetrable steel and will never break because I've been using it my whole life and continue to use it now. You office people are like just rotting away while you talk poorly about us manual labor individuals. And we're the ones who are going to keep fit and juicy. Well, you guys are complaining about your backs and having trouble going up the stairs and losing that virility in your life. But yeah, totally. That's my ancestral ability is manual labor. I've tried office jobs. It just almost killed me, just spiritually, energetically. I was just doomed to fail. I couldn't do it. And then the people suck in those types of environments too. But manual people, they share that blood memory with me too, because a lot of them, they come from the same stock. They come from the same lines of people who work hard. Even my Mexicano amigos, we're not related, but we share that love of hard work, and I respect it. I respect it a lot, and I get along fabulously with them because, there's that crossover, that like top 10 anime crossovers of some freaking Canadian lumberjack and Mexicano amigos, right? But yeah, I mean, hard work. It's been there my whole life. Probably isn't going to change. Not smart enough to be a little desk boy. And good for you for being desk boy, because you're going to make more than me and you're going to have a comfier life than me. And it's obviously better to be intelligent in this society. So, yeah, good for you guys. You guys got the good roll. You guys got the high int roll. I did not. I got the high strength roll, though. I'm pretty glad about that. I got some other high rolls we'll get into later, but yeah, there's something about career and what you excel at professionally when it comes to, and you have generations of people working the same types of industries, generational bankers and people in the military. It's very interesting to see. I wonder if you guys have seen this in your own lives. A lot of people, I remember when veganism was popular in like 2015, vegetarianism. And I actually tried, I didn't try veganism, but I tried going vegetarian because, there's people saying, oh, it's good for energetically and it'll increase your prana and stuff like that, right? So I was like, okay, well, let's give it a shot. And a couple months in, I was doing pretty bad. I was doing pretty bad, and then I had a dream. I had a dream about fried chicken, and I would like to think that fried chicken was my blood memory and my ancestors telling me, it's over. You're not doing this anymore. It's not gonna work for your blood type or your genetics or whatever it is. Maybe some people can do it. I can't. And so I ate the fried chicken the next day, and then I felt like $1 million. It was, I even made a video about it. I wonder if I could find it. Me eating the chicken I recorded. I recorded myself eating that chicken, and it was just the best. It was one of the greatest moments of my life, eating that chicken. I'll never forget it. I could just feel the dopamine hit. Yeah. But Yeah, it's interesting to know that you have people looking out for you. I've definitely had somebody look out for me, man. The freaking amount of mistakes I've made in my life, the close calls, there's something out there helping me because I couldn't do it on my own. Anyway, that's my little chat on blood memory. Blood memory, blood memory, blood memory. Anyone looking for a death metal band or black metal band, just let me know and we'll do some collab. I would like to get some stuff out there. Oh, maybe that's another little venue. Music, right? Some music really activates the blood memory. I'm talking about, the Viking Norse style music, Wardruna type stuff, that really just activates my blood like no other. Even black metal, there's something visceral and primal about that. And then there seems to be like a cultural revival within folk music where, like, real folk, I'm not talking boomer folk music, I'm talking real folk music, right? Like the Mongolian guys doing their stuff and the Viking guys doing their stuff, Slavic people doing their stuff, right? It's like there is this kind of revival happening and it's really awesome to see. And, I think everyone, I don't really so much resonate with the Mongolian stuff because, that's just not there for me, but I'm sure they do, and there's some interesting music coming out for sure. Yeah. So feel free to drop some links in the comments of some good blood and music, and I will see you all the next time. Feel free to join the Discord where we will discuss the blood memory in further detail, I'm sure. And I will see you next time.